Yes, Inya, you can start.
Wish you all a warm evening and a warm welcome to celebration on National Energy Conservation Day and webinar on Conserve the Energy, Save the Future. I now call upon Mr. Komara Prasad of Second Year Triple E to welcome the gathering.
Good evening to everyone gathered here. I am greatly privileged to welcome our respected principal, sir, for inauguration of the webinar on National Energy Conservation Day. Welcome, sir. I have a great privilege of welcoming the chief guest of the day, Mr. C. Arul Kumar, Associate Professor, Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, Power Engineering College, Namakkal. For this one-day webinar, who was kind enough to accept our invitation, and he is having keen interest in enriching the students' community with his knowledge. Welcome, sir. I am pleased to greet our beloved HOD, sir, a warm welcome. Welcome, sir. I also welcome the faculty members to this nice occasion. Also, I extend my words of welcome to my brothers and sisters to this webinar. Once again, I welcome one and all. Thank you.
Thank you, brother. Might I request our respected HOD, sir, to give the special address.
So, okay, ma'am. Arul, sir, can you start your session, sir?
Okay, then. Thank you, Ram.
Might I request our respected chief guest to give us a guest lecture?
So good evening to all. My screen is visible?
Sir, it is visible, sir.
Okay. My audio is clear?
Oh, yeah, clear, sir. Clear. No problem. Okay. No issue.
Okay. So good evening to all. Myself, C. Arul Kumar, Associate Professor from Triple E Department, Power Engineering College. So I am here to talk about conserve energy and save the futures. So it is. So we know we are celebrating National Energy Conservation Day on 14th of December today. So the main motto of this webinar is: so you students should know how to utilize the energy efficiently. So we are not saying don't use the less energy. How effectively you use the electrical energy. So before that, why we are celebrating this National Conservation Day means. So you know, India is the largely populated country. So we are using, we have more industries, so that we use more higher amount of energy conservations. So we are conserving energy. If it is effective, it is not, because most of the energies are wasted due to poor conservation of our people. So that's why the government of India initiate and showcase the exemplary milestone in energy savings. So that's why we are celebrating a National Energy Conservation Day on 14th December of every year. So here, how it is Energy Conservation Day celebrated means, it is formed with the help of a committee, which is known as a Bureau of Energy Efficiency, which is formed in the year 2001, and the committee was formed in the year of 2002 April. So here, this Bureau of Energy Efficiency body is constituted with comes under the Government of India, and it will help the development of it will have some policy strategies in order to reduce the energy uses. So that's why we are celebrating National Energy Conservation Day. So what is the main objective of this National Energy Conservation Day is? So here it is celebrated in every year with some particular theme, by keeping in mind of some goals and objectives to give more effective way to reduce the energy consumption. That is the give the clear energy conservation all over the country among the people. So similarly, it sent the message on people what is the importance of energy consumption of every life of the human. Similarly, it was promoting the process of energy conservation by organizing lot of events some discussions, conference, debates, workshop, competitions, and also some likewise all over the country through school to the people. So it starts from the school level to the all over the people. So main objective is it is promote the people to use less amount of energy by neglecting the excessiveness and wasteful of the energy usage. Similarly, the main objective here is to encourage the people to use more efficient way in order to decrease the energy consumption as well as prevent the energy loss which is happened during conservation of the energy. Okay, so here they are not saying they are not saying to use less energy. You can use your energy when it is required. So if your bulb is turned on unwantedly means that is the wasteful.
Sir, voice is not audible, sir. Arul, sir.
Someone muted my mic, Ram. Wait, I will change the options. When it is muted, Ram?
Now only, sir. Okay, now only.
Okay, wait, I will change the setting. Then after that, I will proceed.
Okay.
Wait a minute. Okay, Ram, if is it audible?
Sir, is it audible? Continue.
Okay. Wait a minute. Okay. So I am talking about energy. So when the people starts to use energy means, so initially the human has realized the usefulness of sun initially, and also they are using their bodies and the animals to burn the energy and use energy as a resource. So this is the initial stage of energy usage. Then after that, long ago the people know the use of water power. By using the water power, they are using a paddle wheels to for the movement of rotating action. Similarly, they know the power of wind for transportation and irrigation purpose. So this is the first the people know the realize the use of energy. So with the water and power, they are generating a rotating motion, and also for transportation purpose they are using a wind power. And after that the people learn the chemical energy. So by using this they can cook the by using wood they are cook and heat their homes. Then because of the modernization, the machinery need more number of energy, because in the 18th century there is an industrial revolution. So they need other type of energy resource, especially from the fossil fuels. So from the fossil fuels we can extract more energy. That is here the heat energy is converted into electrical energy. So here what is the fossil fuel means? Fossil fuel means it is like coal, oil, natural gas. These are all called as fossil fuel. So here these are non-renewable energy sources. Once we can use these coal, oil, natural gas, which is extracted from the air, can be used only once. So we cannot use.
இவன் நம்பர்ல எதுல போஸ்ட் ஆகுமே தெரியாது.
Participant, kindly mute your audio.
Ram, shall I mute all the participants? Ram, shall I mute all the participants?
Okay, sir. So, okay, the feedback is only we have.
But, okay, Ram, I will.
அருள் என்ன ஆச்சு
சார்? இந்த டிஸ்டர்பன்ஸ் வந்துட்டே இருக்கு சார், அதான் மியூட் பண்ணேன்.
ம், மியூட் பண்ணிட்டு எல்லாரையும். ஏன்?
ஓகே ஓகே சார்,
எல்லாரும் மியூட் பண்ணிடு, அட் தி எண்ட் வந்து நம்ம பேசிக்கலாம்.
ஓகே சார், ஓகே. ம், so with the help of fossil fuels, so we can convert the heat energy into electrical energy. Fossil fuel means coal, oil and natural gases, which is extracted from the earth.
Presentation, Arul, presentation is not possible. Now it is okay.
So how the fossil fuels are formed means, so it is formed over millions of years. So it is not simply formed over a 10 years or 20 years duration. It is formed before a million of years because of the decaying plants and animals. So if you use them means, if you use fossil fuel means, we cannot replace the fossil fuel. That is, the fossil fuels cannot be regenerated. That is the main disadvantage of these fossil fuels. So because of the modern world, we need more number of electrical energy. So the majority of energy is depends on the fossil fuel like coal, oil and gas. So because of the modernizations, the requirement of this electrical energy is double for the it is getting doubled by year by year. So so the requirement is very very high. So what we do is we want to search for the alternate energy source. So we cannot depend purely on fossil fuels. So we want to search for any alternate resources. So there are many renewable sources available for fossil fuels, but we have some controversy in this. For example, if you take a nuclear power plant means, so it is able to deliver a power of 25% of power to the world. But we know what happened to the nuclear power plant, because the disposal of this radioactive waste is very difficult, and you know it does create harmless to the human beings. So it is very very difficult to install a nuclear power plant all over the places, but it is capable to deliver 25% of power to the world. But we have some controversy in this. Then we want to search for any other type of electrical energy generation. You know, we have hydro power plant, so we cannot able to have a bigger power plant in the range of gigawatts. Why means, if you have a bigger power plant through the hydro power plant means, so it will create flood during nearby lands, because you know the process of hydroelectric power plant. So that due to flood, it will disturb the normal life of the people which is in and around the power plant. So it is also affect the environment. So we cannot have a bigger power plant, hydroelectric power plant. So we have a small hydroelectric power plant, but we can have we cannot have a such a high power hydroelectric power plant. So that is another disadvantage in hydroelectric. Then what are the other source? So we have wind. So it is a wind power plant which is capable to generate an electricity from the wind with the help of wind turbine blades and a generator. So it is a clean source of renewable energy source, but we have some disadvantage. So we cannot simply rely on wind. So wind is not even for the entire duration. The wind flow is changed day by day, so we cannot purely rely on this wind power plant. So other thing, we have solar power plant. So you know, we have the solar is giving we have more future on solar power plant. The solar we can easily install any places, but here also we have some disadvantage. So you know, the solar energy is available in the daytime only. So during night time, the solar power plant won't generate any electrical energy. So those things you know already. So for all the renewable energy sources, we have some disadvantages. That's why up to now we are purely based on the fossil fuels. Our electrical energy generation is mostly depends on, maximum depends on fossil fuels only. Although we have many power plants, but it is not that much effective like fossil fuels. Similarly, we have many other alternative sources like geothermal, which is using earth natural heat and biomass. So it is an alternative to the gasoline. That is alternative to the gasoline for the power generation. Okay. So these are the various ways of power generation. So we have, so you can categorize the electrical energy into two category. One is non-renewable energy sources. So once the energy is utilized means it cannot regenerate, and then renewable energy sources. So renewable means so we can renew the energy source with the help of this wind, solar, like this. So that is called renewable energy source. So what we do is, so we know in every day we are conserving energy. So what we do is, so while using an electric appliance means, so we want to take utmost care. So while leaving a room means you should turn off the lights if no one's there in the room. Similarly, if you use a particular appliance means you can give the full load to the particular appliance. So then only the particular electrical equipment work under 100% efficiently. Also, it will take actual amount of energy based on the rating. Similarly, while traveling, you should use carpooling, bicycling, and also you want to take the public transport. So unwantedly, we don't want to waste the energy like this. So this is the thing which you want to do in a normal life, which can be done by us in a normal life. So you know, we people lives in earth, so you want to take care, serious look at the energy resource, and you want to conserve the energy properly, because we the people lives in earth. We want to take the serious look, and we want to give the we want to utilize the energy properly. So that's the thing we want to give. So here in this, after that we are going to discuss so what are the things which is happened in energy conservation, and how the Indian government is taking necessary steps to make the people to aware about energy conservation. Then what we people what do do and how to utilize the energy properly, that thing I am going to explain. So before that, you should know what is energy. So how it is measured? You know, all we peoples are conserving energy because so we are the domestic users. We users consuming energy like usage of lights, fan, tube light, TVs, refrigerator, and all. Okay, how this energy is measured, then how the unit is calculated. So you know, many peoples are other department, you don't know how the energy is calculated. So the energy unit is, here we can call it as a kilowatt hour. So why it is called as an, actually the unit of power is kilowatts, but in here the electrical energy measured here, it is given in the way of kilowatt hour. So what it is, kilowatts means normally the energy which is measured in the form of kilowatts only, and that for an 1 hour, for a 1 hour duration, how much of energy we are consuming, that can be calculated. That's why it is unit is kilowatt hour. For example, if I am having a heater, the rating of the heater is 1000 watts. That is, the heater is consuming 1000 watts of power. So if it is run for an 1 hour, if I am plugging the heater for running the heater for 1 hour means, for 1 hour, if it is consuming 1000 watts power means it is consuming one unit. So you know how much of how much it, the EB is charging for one unit. It is approximately 2.50 for domestic that is for our home applications. They are charging only less amount of only 2.50. That is based on the unit calculation. If you consume more amount of unit means the rate will be goes on increasing, but basic rate I am saying 2.5. So if an heater is running for 1000 watts, heater is running for 1 hour means it will consume one unit of electricity. So which means you want to pay 2.5 rupees for this. Okay, likewise, each and every equipment have its own rating that can be mentioned in the particular.
One second, sir.
Yes.
What happened? The slide is not changing, sir. The slide is not changing, sir.
I am not changing the slide, Ram.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you.
It is there in energy conservation. Am I correct?
Okay. Yeah. Okay, sir. Okay.
Okay. So likewise, each and every electrical apparatus will have its own rating that is mentioned in the particular equipment. So if you go and see your refrigerator, means that they can mention the power rating, voltage, current, all the things are mentioned. So not only refrigerator, your grinder, washing machine, all the things will have a rating. Okay. So this is the basic thing you want to know about the electrical energy. Okay. So before going into this, so you know the energy conservation is the people should know about the consumption of electrical energy in proper way. So that's why the government is motivate the people and make the awareness to the people to consume the energy in a proper manner. So that is the motto. Now, what is the importance of energy conservation? Okay, so you know we use energy faster. Example, if you simply turn on a tube light, means it will consume energy. If you simply turn on a refrigerator, means it will consume energy. But you know, in order to produce an energy, in order to produce an electrical power, it will take more work. So the energy consumption is very simple, but the energy production is very, very tougher process. Okay, because you want to extract the coal, oil and natural gas from the earth, and you want to make the process to convert all these things are heated up, and these heat energy is converted into electrical energy, then it is transmitted through the transmission line, and it is received by the receiving station, and then it is distributed to the our consumer. So it is a long process. Okay, it is not a simple process, but if you simply turn on a light, means it will consume power. So the effective usefulness should be that while using an electrical energy. Similarly, the energy resources are limited, because you know the available resource. For example, if you consider a fossil fuel, means it will last only for up to 40 years only. So after that, you want to go for an alternate energy sources. So the energy resources are very, very limited. You know, if you come to India, means the India is capable to generate only 1% of its electrical energy, capable to generate only 1% of resource only. But you know, our population is, if you compare with the worldwide, means we have a 16% of population in the world. So but we have only 1% of energy resources. So think of it. So the energy resources are very, very limited. Similarly, the most of the energy source we are using is cannot be reused or renewed. You know, example, the fossil fuels, coal cannot be renewed, oil cannot be renewed. Once it is burned, means that's all. So it cannot be renewed. Why I am saying about coal and oil, means because in India, 80% of the energy are generated from the non-renewable energy source only. Only 20% of that is renewable. Only 20% of energy is generated from renewable energy sources, which means 80% of energy are from the fossil fuels only. That's why it cannot be renewed or reused. Similarly, we save the country a lot of money when we save energy. You know, all the oils are imported from the foreign itself. You know, India have the reserve of only 30% of its oil capacity, and the remaining 70% are imported from the foreign countries, which means for every year for this, India is spending 150,000 crore rupees for this. Which means what happened? Our economy comes down due to these oil buying itself. So if you use lesser energy, means we save our country. Okay. Similarly, we save our money, we save energy. For example, if you use our LPG gas properly, means if it has come for an extra week, means you can save the energy, which means our money is saved. Similarly, for the electricity usage also. So if you cut for unwanted appliance usage, means it will reduce the electricity bill. So you can save your money when saving energy. Similarly, you can save the energy when you save an energy. For example, if you use an fuel wood for you effectively, means the collection for fuel wood will be gets reduced. So the energy you save spend for collecting fuel wood will also gets reduced. Similarly, energy saved is an energy generator. So if you save an one unit of energy means that is equal to 2% of 2 unit of energy generated. If you say when one unit of energy from your side means that is equivalent to 2 to 3 unit of energy generated. Similarly, if you say when energy means it is reduced pollution. Why means? Because of the burning of fossil fuels, it will create more pollution to the environment. So if you correctly use the energy means, it is also helps to reduce the pollution. So these are the main importance of energy conservation. Ram, someone is unmuted. Ram, kindly unmute. Ram, am I audible, Ram?
Yes, sir, you're audible.
Proceed, it's audible only. Arul sir, can you hear me voice? Sir, it is audible only, sir. You can proceed. Arul sir, can you hear my voice? Arul sir, can you hear my voice, sir?
Ma'am, am I audible, ma'am?
Monopriya,
ma'am?
Sir, audible, sir. Audible, sir. No problem, sir. No issue, sir. You can start the session.
Yes, sir. You are audible. Continue.
So the government is taking many steps to initiate the energy conservation with the help of different initiative. So I will tell you what are the initiative which is given by government. So because before that, what are the importance of energy conservation? So one thing is sustainable development. Another one is global warming. That is the two most important thing of energy conservation. So what is sustainable development? Similarly, so the what is sustainable development means it is not only producing the sufficient energy source, but also it will give the importance of using the energy properly and saving the energy for the future. Okay, how we can achieve this means by simply using a renewable energy source. So not only depends on non-renewable, so it is purely depends on the renewable energy source. Okay, so if you go for a renewable energy source means it will give a pollution free environment so that we can get a healthier life. Similarly, we want to follow the suggestion which is given by the government to the industry as well as the people to reduce the wastage and also give an efficient energy source from the industry. So that is the motto of sustainable development. Similarly, global warming. So in addition to the sustainable development, global warming also reduced. How the global warming happened means because of the burning of fossil fuels, the air gets polluted. So due to this, the temperature of atmosphere of gets increased. It will create a global warming. So because of the fossil fuel combustion, methane and carbon dioxide gases are released through the air. So due to this, the earth is affected by these methane and carbon dioxide. Okay. So if you use a renewable energy source, means we can also reduce the this global warming issues. Okay. How we can improve the energy efficiency? So we can do by ourselves. So this is done with some technological upgradation, because we are doing nowadays itself. So nowadays in your home, we are having a normal tungsten lamp before that. After that, we can have a CFL lamp. Nowadays, all the CFL lamps are replaced by LED lamps. Why means, if you use a normal tungsten lamp, means if it is consuming 100 watts of energy and it will give some illumination, means the same 100 watts output power can be achieved in a LED with the help of a 10 watts power. So that 10 watts of LED bulb will able to give a same illumination level of an 100 watts tungsten bulb. So the LED bulbs are more efficient, and also you know the normal tungsten bulb will give an heat. So many people are known, but although the rate of the tungsten bulb is low, but while coming to the output the power consumption, the LED bulb is having a good power output, as well as the life of the LED bulb is longer. For example, if a simple tungsten bulb lifetime is 100,000 hours, means the life of the LED bulb was 8,000 hours. Similarly, if instead of using petrol vehicles or diesel vehicles, you can go with a CNG vehicle. Nowadays, we can have a battery operated vehicle is the major thing which is going on. So because of using this, the air pollution is gets arose. So you know what is the use of this petrol or diesel vehicles? The air gets polluted. So if you go an alternate way like a CNG or a battery vehicle, means that will reduce the air pollution. Similarly, so in older days, we can have a conventional coal plant. So here, the efficiency of the coal plant is only 50%. So if it is replaced with a super critical one, means it will give a 45% more energy efficiency compared with the conventional one. So these are the things which is used to improve the energy efficiency. Similarly, wastage prevention. How we can prevent the wastage? Example, first of all, you want to switch off the electricity and appliance when it is not in use. So either use alarm irko, just simply switch off. Similarly, you want to replace the old socket with new one. Why I am saying old socket means it will consume power because of the lifespan, the old sockets will consume. So you want to replace with the new ones. Similarly, using smart grid technology. So what is smart grid technology means? We have some advanced metering system, circuit breakers and all. By using this, the losses in the lines also in the distribution sites are gets reduced. Similarly, prefer the public transport. So instead of going in as if I am having a single person, for single person I am opting for a single car, means so it doesn't wastage of energy. So instead of using a car, you can go for a public transport, or you can use a carpooling to reduce the air pollution. So these things which can be done by ourselves only. Okay. Similarly, next is optimum utilization of energy. So optimum utilization means, so that can be done for industries, office and buildings. So we want to create an appropriate infrastructure for this, and we want to create a right selection of building materials, and also you want to create a green building optimization for renovating the residential areas and environment. Similarly, we want to reduce the energy conservation and water usage by constructing a green building initiative. So that thing which is initiated by the government itself. So these are the various way to optimize the utilization of electrical energy resources. Similarly, now the government is give some certification like green city certifications. So here, what is the main motto of this green city certification means? Here we have a thing that is the development is done in a densely populated area which is concentrated on the center of the town. So because of this, the concentration is mainly on the high density area, means they want to provide the adequate water and transport facility. Similarly, they just omit the outskirt of the area is not having major construction. That is the main motto of this green city certification. Similarly, the buildings which is constructed using green cities are obey the rules which is set by the government by the green building projects. Similarly, the peoples will have an eco-friendly life, and also they can enjoy the life of the green city. So if these things are happen, means the people will have the habit to part is habit of energy conservation. So that is the main motto of this green city certifications. Similarly, by using clean technology, so that can be done by the transmission and distribution side. That is cogeneration. What is cogeneration means? For example, in a power plant, the coal is heated, so heat energy is produced. That heat energy is converted into electrical energy. So here, all the heat are not converted into electrical energy. So the wastage of heat can be utilized for any other purpose, by for heating of where any other uses. So that can be used. Similarly, you can able to generate an off-grid power. Off-grid renewable power means, for example, in my house, I can have a own solar power plant. So here, that thing will generate an energy that can be stored in a simple battery. So that energy can be utilized for our household application. That is called off-grid renewable energy source. And third thing is perform achievement rate. This is the financial activity that is given by the government. So you have some certification and we have some generation. So that can be given to government. So they can do the perform achievement rate. So that is the motto which is given by BAT. So our ultimate aim is we are not going to use a non-renewable energy source. So you can go for a renewable energy source. So in order to use renewable energy source, our government of India will do a more initiative. So it is planned to set up 175 gigawatts of energy in the country in the form of power plants like wind, 60 watts of wind gigawatts of wind power plants, 100 gigawatts of solar power plants, and 10 gigawatts of biomass efficient energy power plants, and 5 gigawatts of hydro power plants. So these are the renewable energy sources. So they are making it to implement in the near futures. So you know what are the renewable energy sources means? We have wind energy. So India is the fourth largest country which is extracting the wind power. So we have a capacity of 5,400 megawatts of power in and around our country. Similarly, we have a scheme called National Offshore Wind Energy Policy Plan, which is used to extract the wind power across a 760 kilometer long coastline. So it is there in India. Similarly, in India, the National Wind Energy Mission proposed to add a 60 megawatts of wind energy in the year 2020 to achieve a target of 4,000 megawatt wind energy in a states. So these are the various activities which is done by our Indian government for generation of renewable energy sources. Similarly, for biofuels also, they are adding more initiative. So that has happened with the help of some MOUs with Indo and the USA. In order to produce a second generation power biofuels. And also they are planning to have a small hydro plant. So we can don't have a large hydro plant. I told you we have some disadvantage, like we can stop the flow of natural water flow. Similarly, we have a flood in the large area under the reservoir. Similarly, it will affect the forest land. Also, you want because of this, it will create a methane emissions. Similarly, there is a problem of deforestation and slidation, etc. Similarly, there is a if you have a hydro power plant means, so sometimes you want to relocate the peoples which is in and around of the power plant. So these are all a very difficult process for large hydro power plant. So that's why the government is planned to have a small hydro power plant which is up to 25 megawatts capacity. So that small hydro power plant can be classified into three categories. One is micro, which is up to 100 kilowatts, where mini is the 100 to 2000 kilowatts, and a small hydro plant means 2000 to 25,000 kilowatts. Where these small hydro power plant are not run by government, it is only private. Private are the main investor for the small hydro power plants. Similarly, solar energy. So in India, in 2070, we are harvest up to 10 gigawatts of power from the solar. But government is having more initiative to harness the solar power. So we have a separate department to harness the solar power. So that is described with called as Jawaharlal Nehru National Solar Mission, which is initiate the more number of power plant implementation in various areas. So that is the another source of renewable energy sources. Similarly, waste to energy. Similarly, you know, by using from the organic waste from the urban or rural area industry, so it is get degraded so that it will produce an energy sources. So in India, by using this waste to energy, we are realizing up to 2% of waste to energy potential. Up to now, the India is able to extract only 2% of waste to energy potential, which is coming from the organic waste, also from the industry. So that is this is given by the agency called Indian Renewable Energy Development Agency, which is used to develop this waste to energy project. So they are trying to extract more number of energy from the waste. So in India, we have a large waste to energy plant, which is inaugurated in the year 2017 in Narla to Bauna. So these are the various types of renewable energy system, which is available in India, and by various amount of power generation, which is indicated. Now, how the government is making initiation for energy conservation? So the energy conservation is done with the help of only the BEE, which is called as a Bureau of Energy Efficiency, which is formed in the year 2001 under the Ministry of Power. So it is a standalone body. It is coming under Ministry of Power. The main motto is to develop a strategic policies for energy conservation. That is the main motto of this BEE. So there are various projects which is given by this BEE. The first thing is Jawaharlal Nehru National Missions. So this is the special thing which is proposed only for solar energy. So here in the near futures, in the year 2021-22, they can implement a 20,000 megawatts of solar energy, and they are planned to increase up to 1 lakh megawatts in the near futures. So here, this is a sub-initiative from the Ultra Mega Solar Power Project, and it is administrated by the Solar Power Corporation of India. It is a separate team which monitor the this solar power. And we have some other agency called National Missions for Enhanced Energy Efficiency. So these are the various activities which is performed by this government. One is called the Perform, Achieve and Trade Scheme. So here we have some certification for clean energy utilization. And we can have a framework of energy efficient economic development. So here some framework is formed for development of energy efficiency. Then energy efficiency financing program. So it is a financial sector. So the government is having some tie up with a bank like HSBC and some other banks to give some loans to the industries to make the energy conservation more effective. So that is called energy efficiency financing program. Then we have market transformation for energy efficiency. So this is for the, because by using the latest trends and new technology, how we can utilize the energy properly, that can be achieved with the help of this market transformation for energy efficiency. So these are the various activities which is done by our government of India in order to enhance the efficiency of the energy. So apart from this, they can have some other renewable energy purchase obligations. So here, it is mainly applicable to the distributor of electricity, high profile consumer, because we people, we are the domestic user, we are using less amount of energy. If you go for industry means, they are the bulk consumers where they can recommend is in the range of kilowatts and megawatts. So they can have some interaction with these people and have some agreements. So for industries, they can have set some threshold level. So the government will set them some threshold level of power consumption through renewable energy. So the government asks the particular industry to consume the power, a particular amount of power from the renewable energy source itself. Because many industry will have their own power plant, like solar power plants, wind power plant by its own. So they are selling the power to the government. So that is the motto. So they are selling the power So the amount of energy which is utilized by the industry can be some percentage of energy utilized to, is from the renewable energy source itself. So that is the main motto of renewable power purchase obligation scheme. And this is the biofuel. So here main motto is to you instead of using petroleum product, they are used to sell ethanol blended petrol in the market. So here they are using a 22.5% of ethanol and 15% of diesel for sale. It is also proposed by our Indian government. And next one is a National Clean Energy Fund. This is launched by Indian government in the year 2010 to 11. Here they are using a smart grid technology by using a latest equipment like smart metering and all. Similarly, the National Clean Energy Fund is mainly utilized for renewable energy source only. Similarly, use of fossil fuels also, clean fossil fuels also included in order to modify the coal gasification and coal bed methane. So that thing also done with the help of this National Clean Energy Fund. And also using energy efficient lights like using LEDs and all for near futures. So that is the motto of this National Clean Energy Fund. Similarly, this is the Green Energy Coordinated Project. So this is also a government initiative project, which is done, given fund to the each and every state to have a green energy city in the...
Niveda! Nivi, na pesu undu kecha.
Ah, vidindra.
Sir, I can remove the person, so you can start, sir. Hello, sir.
Wait, Ram.
Ah, okay, sir, I can remove that person, no problem, sir. You can start.
So likewise, we have many, many schemes which is given by our government of India to conserve the energy in a proper manner. So these are the various scheme, various agency which is give funding as well as non-funded agency to give various ways to use the energy proper manner. Okay. So this is about the various functions, that is various things which is done by our government of India initiative to use the energy properly. But we people, what we do, how we can conserve the energy properly means, so I will give some ways to conserve energy properly. So we are the domestic consumers where we are consuming energy. How we can use the energy properly means, so these are the some tips. So first of all, in industry, so most of the industry loads are electric motor. So all the industry are run with the help of an electric motor. So the proper choice of electric motor is an important thing for the energy efficiency. So you want to select an proper energy efficient motor, and also you know the motor are variable speed drives, so that control also properly selected and correct size and rating of the motor. Because for example, my load requirement is very low, but I am having a higher rating motor means, so here the motor will always operate at its rated capacity only, which means the motor is not run up to its rated power only, rated load, not running its rated load. So which means here the energy is wasted. Similarly, regular and routine maintenance will be needed to make the motor more efficiency. Similarly, power factor also play a major role. If you have poor power factor means we have more losses. So power factor correction devices also in implemented in industry. So those things are done in industry, but we people in our system, in our normal life cycle, how we can conserve the energy properly means, first of all, it starts from the lighting system. So you know, now all we people are using lights. So nowadays the LED bulbs are more efficient than the CFL bulb. For example, in your home you can have a normal tube light which is of rating of 40 watts, but if the same illumination of 40 watts, the same LED bulb will able to consume only 20 watts of power. So you know, we have LED as well as a fluorescent lamp. So the same fluorescent lamp will consume a 40 watts power and it will give us some illumination. For the same illumination, the LED bulb will consume only 20 watts power, which means half of the power consumption is gets reduced. So while purchasing a new light or new tube, means I request you to purchase only LED tube. Similarly, the lifespan of the LED tube was very higher than the CFL bulb. So normally a CFL bulb can work only for 1000 hours or 2000 hours, but the LED can able to work up to 8000 hours. Also, it consumes lesser energy. This is the first task for you. So instead of using a CFL bulb, go for an LED bulb. Similarly, while using a lighting system, for example, if you have many rooms, so you are unwantedly you are turning on the lights. So instead of using all the room lights, you can go for a task lighting. What is task lighting means? Where the requirement is there means that place only you can use the lights. So that is called a task lighting. Similarly, you can use the light colored surface. Why I am saying means the light colored surface will reflect the more light. So compared with dark, because dark is absorbing the light and light surface will reflect the lights. That's why my advice is always use a light colored surface in your workspace, which means the number of lamp requirement also gets reduced. Similarly, while placing the lamp, you should place at the corners, because then only it will reflect, all the lights are reflected from the walls, so you can get the efficient illumination in the all over the place. So this is in the lighting system. Similarly, while using an air conditioning, you know, most of the domestic applications, the air conditioner is the consuming more energy. Compared to all other electrical appliances, the air conditioning system are consuming more electrical energy. So normally, if you use normal days, if you use a ceiling fan, means it will consume a very, very less amount of energy than the air conditioning system. While using an air conditioning system, you keep in mind of these points. So if you set a temperature of 22 degrees centigrade, means it will give more. Instead of setting 18 degree or 19 degree, if you set a 22 degree centigrade, means it will give 3 to 5% of energy. Because for 22 degree centigrade, it is recommendable and it can bearable for this temperature. It is bearable. So if you increase the temperature to 25 degree, means that's for the same air conditioner, we can get higher amount of energy efficiency and also better comfort. So that is the my advice while using an air conditioner. Okay. Similarly, you know, normally air conditioner is you cool and reduce the humidity level in an half an hour time period itself. So after half an hour, you can switch off the AC. So for that, you can set this timer, or you can make it in a sleep mode, because within a half an hour period, it will cool the entire room. Also, the humidity of the level of the room also gets reduced. So that is the third thing. Similarly, while using an air conditioner, you remove the dust which is formed in the filter, because if dust is formed, means the loading effect to the air conditioner will be more, because so that the air AC will take more time to cool the room. So you just clean the remove the dust which is there in the AC. Similarly, you can place the AC in a west or south faced wall, because this west and south walls are more exposed to the sunlight during the major parts. So in India, south and west walls are mostly exposed to the sun. It is directly exposed by the sun. So don't place the AC in a south and west walls. Okay, so always place the AC in a north and east side of the wall. Okay, so this is the proper way of using air conditioner for the energy consumption. Similarly, while using a refrigerator, by proper usage, you just keep the freezer temperature at very low. So which means it will increase the energy level to 20 to 30% higher. So just keep the actual required temperature for the refrigerator. For example, during summer days we require more cooling, means you can increase the, you can decrease the temperature, but during the this period our requirement cooling requirement is very high, very low only. So that point of time you can increase the temperature of the air conditioner. Similarly, same thing for this refrigerator, don't place in a west and south facing wall. Also make some keep some distance between the wall spacing, because this refrigerator also creates some heat outside of the room. So it will may take some time to cool the make cool the things which is there in the refrigerator. So kindly play make don't place near the west and south facing wall. Similarly, before placing the food items, it should be cooled, because if you have a hot food means it will take it will overload the refrigerator. So make it cool down, then after that you place it near refrigerator. That is the other point. Similarly, don't open the cover of the liquid item, because the liquid item gets vaporized in the refrigerator. So the liquid item should be properly sealed while placing in the refrigerator. Similarly, don't make the refrigerator door open for a long time. So which means the so because of opening the door, the refrigerator will take more time to cool. So that is the another thing. Similarly, you want to clean the refrigerator coil regularly in order to reduce the loading effect in the refrigerator. So this is the thing which is to be carried out while using a refrigerator. Similarly, while using a washing machine. So you know, so washing machine, proper usage of washing machine is needed. Similarly, the while using a washing machine, proper planning is done, because while using a washing machine, you use a full load capacity of the washing machine. Similarly, it conserves water also. So if you load the washing machine off means it will take actual time to wash the cloth. So here also the energy are waste. Similarly, don't use too much of detergent in washing machine. So it will cost, it will make more time to wash the cloth. So for this, you make some choke or free wash the cloth for effective cleaning before putting into the washing machine. So these things to be done while using a washing machine. Similarly, water heater and gisser. So you know, we have an gisser where it will heat the water. So if you simply turn on the gisser, means actually we have sensor which is there in the gisser. So it will maintain a 45 degree centigrade of temperature, but at some point of time after 40 when it reaches 45 degree means automatically the sensor will cut down the coil and so it won't heat up the water. But at some point of time the water temperature will cools down. If it reaches 43 degree or 42 degree means once again the sensor will sense that the temperature is decreasing, so that the coil is once again turned on and once again it will gets heated. This process is repeated, which means your water AC is running for all days.
Arul sir, your voice is breakable, sir. Arul sir, your voice is not audible.
Ram, am I audible?
Audible, sir. Audible, sir. You can continue, sir.
So you can go for a solar water heating system for also. So it will save our energy. Similarly, you can go for a BEE labeled. So while purchasing an electrical appliances, there is some BEE rating. So this is called Energy Star Rating. This star rating was given by this Bureau of Energy Efficiency. So we have some star rating from 1 star to 5 star. So if you are purchasing an electrical equipment with higher star rating, means it will consume less amount of power, even though it may be costlier, but in future it will consume less energy. So normally if an simple star rated, if you purchase a simple star rated BE label, means it will give a 10 to 20% more energy efficiency, even though it will be costlier, but consumption of power gets reduced. So my recommendation is, at least you can purchase a 3-star rated BEE equipment for our future use. For all the electrical equipments, they can star rating, which is given by the Indian government under the help of this BEE, that is Bureau of Energy Efficiency. But the product cost may be higher, but it will give good efficiency that can be reasonable while using the equipment. So which are the equipments we have Energy Star Rating? Means these are the equipments where the cloth washers, dryers, dishwashers, refrigerator, computer, TV, furnace and AC, all the things will have this energy rating. So you can go for any appliance shop, means they can, in the front side, they can have on label which is mentioned 2-star rating, 3-star rating, 4-star rating, 5-star rating. For our usage, 5-star is now not required. You can go for 3-star rating or 4-star rating, even though I experienced. So I replaced a refrigerator. So before replacing the refrigerator, my old one consuming high amount of power, where it is my electricity bill was around 1,000 rupees for 2 month period. But after replacing the new one with the double door refrigerator with the 3-star rating, actually my electricity bills are goes down to 500 rupees. This is what I actually experienced with a 3-star rated refrigerator. So because my old one is bought in the year of 1992, that period we don't have any energy rating and energy efficiency things, which is not to be considered. But nowadays we have some BE rated efficient electrical apparatus, where my electrical consumption gets reduced drastically. This is what I experienced in the last year. So this is the thing which is there in an office, where we have some unwanted, that is common items which is used. So that thing will be placed in a common place. Also, we have a window where it is given good lightning, but here they are unwantedly switch on the lights. So which means they are not properly conserve the energy. So that is the thing which I want to show you. Similarly, here they can have some common equipment. So these equipments can be used in a common place when required, means you can use, but for an individual person, it is not required. So that thing which I want to show you. So these are the things which is not required. It is placed in a common places. So see here. So these are the equipment. So these numbers are indicating the unwanted equipment. So that can be replaced like this. So if you have these equipments, means that is efficient. So these equipments can be used commonly. Commonly in an office, which means it is an energy efficient way to conserve the energy. Similarly, you people, when leave, you are the first person to enter the room, means kindly switch on the required fan and light only. Don't switch on all the fan and light when it is not required. Similarly, if you are the last person to leave the room, means kindly turn off all the lights and the fans which is there in the room. So that's the thing you should do in your life. That is the proper way to conserve the energy. So here in this example, he used a task light because it is actually it is not required. Only task light is required. So he is using the task light only. That is the proper way to conserve the energy. So finally, so our Indian government is taking lot of action to make the people to conserve the energy in a proper manner by implementing more number of measures up to now. So that is done by our government, but we are the responsible people. So we want to practice the eco-friendly way of living and use the energy in a sustainable manner. Similarly, you want to adhere the you want to follow the various policies and principles which is given by our government, means we can use the energy in an efficient manner. So together we have power to save energy. So our effort is the our effort will make the difference. Thank you all.
Thank you so much, sir. Your very informative presentation.